we're now going to discuss a possible error situation that can occur on a PWM30 controller. If the controller starts to flash, it's usually because there's a voltage of more than 15.5 volts that's been applied to the battery. This puts the controller into an error state. So I can simulate it here with a power supply, and the unit will start to flash. There's only a number of ways of getting rid of the error. Either you lower the battery voltage. If you lower the battery voltage back to an acceptable rate, then it'll stop. It's usually caused by an unregulated converter that's put a spike to the battery and put the controller into an error state of over 15.5 volts, or an alternator from a vehicle that's charging the batteries as well and puts it above this state. You can also, once it's flashing, try what's called a soft reset on the controller. So if it's flashing and you get your voltage down again above the below the 15.5 volt rate, and you're able to hold all four buttons down, it'll stop the flashing from occurring. It's called a soft reset. Sometimes you have to hold the buttons for anywhere between 5 to 12 seconds. The other thing that may stop the flashing is if you've got too large of a solar bank for too small of a battery bank. The one thing you can do in that situation is to cover the panels with a piece of cardboard and see if the flashing stops. If the flashing does stop, the next step would be to try what's called a hard reset on the controller, where you disconnect all four wires on the back of the controller, isolate the controller for about a half hour so that it slowly discharges and loses its error rate, then reconnect the controller, battery wires first, then solar wires, and see if the flashing continues. If it does, simply disconnect the solar wires on their own and see if it stops. If you get to that stage, it may be that there's an issue with the solar controller. Another option to solve the problem would be to add a secondary battery.